I didn't picture myself celebrating New Year's by making a Jalen Smith video, but here we are. He was a lone bright spot for the Suns last night as they got dismantled by the Celtics. I'll talk about Jalen more towards the end of this short video. I wanted to focus on how the Celtics, who have been struggling as of late, beat the Suns so badly. Booker and CP3 struggled from the field last night, but I was fine with the shots that Booker took. I was not fine with the shots that CP3 took. When I watched this game, I think he only took one or two open shots. The rest were contested. That was really just a one-game instance though. We know the Suns have a three-level offense with Ayton, who was out tonight. The lopsided victory was more than the Celtics just being able to run an offense for once, as they ran through their bigs last night, and they both combined for 17 assists. Rob Williams is shaping up to be a really good passer. He hits Josh Richardson, another important player for the Celtics tonight. The Suns were running a switch defense, and the way to beat that is by a lot of off-ball movement and cutting. Here he hits Grant Williams, who uses his size on Devin Booker. This is a really nice pass from Robert Williams, as most centers wouldn't even consider taking that type of pass. The Celtics don't have a lot of facilitators, so this is going to be key for their offensive function. Here it is again, a really nice pass, and the Celtics run a 5 out so that Grant Williams can get easy post position with no big in the paint. It happens again here, but it's Al Horford passing it this time. Moving on to Jalen Smith, he became an afterthought after playing his rookie year mainly in the G League. The last 3 games he's been getting real minutes, and he's been putting up good stats to show for it. From watching his past 3 games, admittedly, his points and rebounds were generated really easily. But if you're the Suns, you're just hoping for signs of being an NBA player. Last year, the Suns, after losing Saric, had nobody play. They had to play Kaminsky, and that was really rough. He's really mobile for being 6'10", and he has a nice jump shot form. He's been hitting his free throws, and it's only a matter of time where his other shots fall in. I really hope the Suns continue to keep playing him even when Ayton comes back. He's a really young and confident player, and most importantly, he wears goggles, so that just means that he's destined for greatness.